I mentioned that I was having plantar anxiety again and I was kind of all over the place. And I decided to go back into my Midori Traveler's notebook. And right now I've moved all of my stuff back into this blue Pan Am limited edition and I love it. Although I did love my Me and My Big Ideas happy planner, I figured out part of the problem is that I'm getting too hung up on this kind of stuff. I'm getting too hung up on the decorations and the scrapbooking stuff and like all of this stuff and having to set aside time to plan out layouts. And you know, I feel like I have to set it up, I have to add all this stuff. And it was getting to be pretty overwhelming. And although I do enjoy this, I do like, you know, doing these things as a creative outlet, but I've got a lot of stuff going on in life right now, and I didn't really like feeling the pressure that I had to do all of this. And in my Midori, I don't feel that pressure at all. In fact, in one of the Facebook groups, we were discussing how the Midori just kind of feels like an old friend. It's comforting, it's organic, it's peaceful. And here it's like my OCD kicks in, and I don't like it if I make a mistake, or I don't know. I can't bring myself to use a planner like this that looks plain. I wish I could be one of those people that could just take a pen and write in all of their appointments and do all of, you know, their planning and whatnot that they need to do without having to, you know, add all of these things and do all of this. I wish I could do that. I'm just not one of those people, but for whatever reason, I can do that in here. And so I am gonna put this down for a little while, and you know, I may move back into this. I do change planners a lot. I'm constantly, you know, changing things up and moving things around, but for now, where I'm at in my life, I just need to kind of go back to the basics and just go back into here. I don't feel like I need to set aside time to make this look beautiful and add stickers and washi tape. I do add a little bit of, you know, travel vintage related things into my Midoris. It's nothing crazy at all. In fact, I use my words as the decorations a lot of times. I feel more compelled to want to write in here. If I do decide to, you know, add a few things, I'll add like some vintage travel related washi tape. I also like to use, you know, a lot of neutral colors, a lot of vintage postage stamps, stickers like this. These are from Cavallini and Company. I believe this is the French ephemera pack, I believe, and I just love, love, love these. And these are, you know, the types of things that I like to use in my Midoris. And I just like the neutral colors. And again, I don't feel a lot of pressure to have to go in here, you know, to decorate. And if something's, you know, not perfect, it's okay. Matter of fact, you know, my Midoris are not perfectly decorated. They're not perfectly organized. And, you know, it's actually okay with me. I do own other handcrafted leather notebook covers from other artisans, and I do love those. I will continue to use those. But for whatever reason, right now, my original Midoris are definitely helping me. They're definitely bringing peace back into my life where I felt like over here and being in a whole bunch of books was just getting way too out of hand and way too chaotic. And like I said, I may go back to this, but for now, this is where we're at, and I think I'm really going to enjoy that. I also use this little guy, my little passport size Midori as well. I can just throw this into my purse. I can jot down notes. I can keep this by my nightstand to help me, you know, remember things that I need to plan or put in here later on. And it's just very simple. I've got this Tomoe River paper insert from the Owl Stationers, and I just have the plain craft folder, a monthly insert, and just the blank Midori insert that it came with. And that's all I have in here. And you know, this is perfectly fine. It's perfectly portable. It doesn't cause me any stress. I love this. I love having that. And like I said, you know, I am a girly girl. I do like these girly things, but right now I think I'm just burnt out on all of that. And in the event that I do, you know, need a creative outlet and I do want to, you know, work with stickers and washi tape and all of that stuff again, I can. I do have my brown Midori, and like I said in my previous video, I just have two inserts in here, and they are for creative challenges, and I do participate in the Creative Midori Challenge, and again, I will link Florence Antoinette's videos down below if you're interested. But even, you know, there's a prompt every day, and then you can do whatever you want to do on the page. And even though there's one every day, sometimes I fall behind, sometimes I skip some, but you know, it's just okay. I have this insert in there, along with these dashboards that I showed you guys last time, and I did get a question on these, and I will try to remember. I think I linked Erin Joy's video in my last video, but I will link it again. She is the one who, I watched a video of hers, and she inspired me to make my own dashboards, and these are the ones that I like to kind of use in my blue Midori, like travel related ones, and these are made out of wrapping paper from Cavallini and Company, and the wrapping paper is not double-sided, so I just took two sheets and glued them on top of one another, and these are completely reversible, so you know, I can use it either way, and so I just like to have these on hand. You know, it does add some color, and they are functional. They do protect my notebooks. They are a great place to house some sticky notes as well. And so I like doing like the vintage travel themes here in my main Midori, which I'm now using as a planner and my journal. This houses all of my daily stuff. And so far, I am back to loving it. Again, if I do add a few decorations, they're just, you know, just random travel related things. I really, really love vintage travel. Matter of fact, all of these cards came in the Coco Daisy monthly kit, and I just received these today, and I love, love, love the theme. It was so cute, and I just love all of these little cards, and they also included these little clips as well. If you guys are looking for any kind of monthly planner subscription, I have really been enjoying Coco Daisy. I do get several different ones every month, and I really liked the theme for this month. But as you can see, here is my Chunky Monkey. I do have a little bit of overhang. I know it looks a little bit worse than it actually is. Sorry about that, you guys. My phone died, and I will try to finish up this video. But anyway, what I was saying is I've moved everything back in here, and it definitely is chunky. I do have the all of the Pan Am inserts as well as some other ones, the Pan Am zip pocket and the craft folder in here. And I was saying that it looks like I've got a lot of overhang on camera. I think it's just the angle. It's actually not too bad. It was a miracle that I was able to get all of this stuff in here. This is a new insert for me. I have never used this one before, and I'm going to try this one out, and I'm really looking forward to see if, you know, this will work better for me. And again, as you guys can see, I do have, you know, a few stickers here and there. I do have here's my other half of my dashboard. I left all of the Pan Am inserts the way that they were. And then I've got this one back here to put, you know, my travel related stickers, and there's some boarding passes, just random, you know, stuff if I get in the mood to do some collaging or something. But everything is pretty simple. I don't have a lot of decorations at all, and I don't feel the pressure to have to do that, and I'm really enjoying that. Matter of fact, here is August, and all I did was add some of the stickers. I put August down the side and put some stickers across the bottom, and that was it. I just added in some appointments and some birthdays, and that was basically it. And you know, this was not stressful at all. and I don't have to worry about it. It's actually working for me. It's more functional. I'm not all stressed out about everything. So this is what I'm using now, and I will update you guys next time on how it's going and how I'm using it and if my setup or anything changes. I also wanted to show you guys really quickly, I did have a question about what I have in my Kipling 100 pens case, so I will show you guys that really quickly. Right now all I have are these Korean pens. These are kind of similar to the Staedtler pens, and I don't use these a whole lot, but in case I'm on the go and I do need some color, they are here. I do have this is the Midori card holder, and I do have some Starbucks cards with just some travel related vintagey kind of washi tape that I might use on the go. I don't really use this very often, but in case I want to, at least it's there. I don't have very much stuff in here. I just have a travel watercolor set. I've got a few calligraphy pens, my Lamy Safari pen, which I am in love with. This pen right here, you can use to write on washi tape. And I love these as well, just for on the go. It's a Pilot Varsity disposable fountain pen in black. Love these. And I've just got a few mechanical pencils, and that is pretty much it. So I am in the process of paring down and simplifying things and not being so obsessed with all of the decorations and all of the scrapbooky page layouts and all of that stuff. And let me know how you guys kind of feel about this. Again, I may go back to it. I don't know. Right now, it's just something that is just kind of adding more pressure to me that I don't really need or want at the moment. Let me know if you guys have started something new, or if you guys are completely good with doing all of your monthly and weekly, you know, decorating and all of that, or if it's something that you guys do get sick of once in a while. Please let me know in the comments. I'm just kind of curious on how you guys feel about that. And again, if you guys are looking for something, you know, simple to have a creative outlet, I do recommend like a lot of these different Listeners Got a List, the Midori challenges. Like I said, don't be too hard on yourself. If you guys miss one or skip one, it's not a big deal. You can go back to it later. At least you have something, you know, in the event that you know, have time and you want to, you know, get into all of that stuff again. But let me know. And those of you guys who are enjoying your Midori Traveler's Notebooks, let me know what you guys are using them for. If you guys have switched out of another planner to go back into your Midori, please let me know. As always, if you guys have any questions or would like to see anything more in depth, please let me know. And I will talk to you guys later. I hope you have a great week. Thank you for watching. Bye-bye.